Hey guys, this is Julie Custis for the assignment one personal profile video. So what am I most grateful for? I'm definitely most grateful for my family and their support. What am I most proudest of? I would have to say that I'm most proudest of just getting to college and finally getting to my senior year. The happiest moment of my life so far, it's hard to choose, but I'd have to say getting my dog, just because I love her so much. The hardest moment of my life would have to be probably choosing which school to come to, just because it depended on how far I wanted to be from my family. Obviously, if I liked the campus and things that we all kind of went through when choosing, but how I got through it is depending on my family and just my mentors and friends that I had growing up. As a child, I would say I was rather happy. I was the baby of the family, so I kind of got spoiled, I'm not gonna lie. Who's been the kindest to me? Probably my best friend, Caitlin. We've been best friends since my freshman year of high school, and she just would do anything for me, and I would do anything for her. If I could honor one person in my life, living or dead, I'd probably have to honor my grandpa. He's still living, thankfully, but I would just love to honor him because he worked really hard in his lifetime, and I mean now he lives in a nursing home and isn't able to walk really and do much, but he had a really rough upbringing, and so I would like to honor him for all of his hard work and sacrifices that he did to help my mom have a great life growing up. And if I could honor, Okay, so tell us a little bit about your family. I have two older brothers. Tony is 32 and Michael is 30. I'm really close to my brothers and yeah, they're cool. I have I have my parents, my mom and my dad. My mom is a project manager for Nokia, and then my dad is a part-time graphic designer, and then I have a dog named Angel that I told you about, and I also have a boyfriend. His name is Ryan, and he's a firefighter near a town by home, and we live in Naperville, Illinois, which is a suburb of Chicago. My three favorite social recreational activities, I definitely love anything outdoors, so like biking, going on walks, even runs if I'm feeling active, which is rare. I also really like coffee, so I like going to try different coffee shops. I also like to cook, but I just have to be really motivated to do it because I don't like messing up, so I really have to know what I'm doing. The riskiest thing I've ever done is gone zip lining in Lake Geneva, and that was definitely my most unforgettable experience as well. It's a lot of fun. I recommend it. The top five things I want to do before I'm 30. I would like to get married before I'm 30, along with having kids before 30, just because I know the health risks that could be involved with that. I would also like to go to Europe. I really want to see Paris, and I think it would be cool to see Spain or Italy as well. So it's three things. I would like to buy my own car, like buy my first car, since my parents technically own my car now, and then possibly buy a house before 30. Living on the wild side. Something that I have done that no one in the class has done. Well, I know this is really random, but I'm not very adventurous, so I'm going with this. I drive a Nissan 2006 Murano, so I don't think anyone in the class has ever done that. If you have, let me know. But it has to be a 2006. It has to be. If I could have lunch with anyone living or dead, who would it be? I would want to have lunch. Jessica Mendoza. She is a she graduated from UCLA and played softball there. I'm a really big softball fan, so she was a really good softball player. She played for the Olympic team. She's also now an MLB analyst, which is really awesome for what she's doing for females. And just in a very male-dominated industry, I think that's great for her. I'd like to listen to that. What books have shaped my thinking? Ooh, that's hard. But I definitely like mental toughness books since I'm an athlete, or just motivational books. But one in specific is called Mind Gym. Why I came to Bradley? I came to Bradley, I mean, it was, I got recruited to play on the softball team, which was a big deciding factor, but I also just really like the campus, and the size of it, the size of the classes. All my professors know my name, which is really nice. I would rather be known as my name than by a number, like my ID number. So that's really appreciative. And the three best courses that I've taken at Bradley, I really enjoyed Comm 160 with Dick House, and I also liked Comm 292 and Comm 393, which were both with Cash. And I just really liked the classmates that I had in that class. We all got along, and every class was just really fun, and the discussion was fun. My three least favorite courses, the top, won't ever change, is Math 111. I know a lot of communication majors have to take that. I just didn't like it. I don't like math, hence why I'm a comm major. And then I didn't like art, like the gen ed art class that we have to take, or if you decide to take it. There's that one. And then I did not like Comm 400, which I took last semester, which is comm research. And I just really didn't like doing the research. It wasn't my thing. What do I want to do when I grow up? Ooh, that's a really loaded question, but I think it would be fun to be a coach, but that's a possibility. Maybe down the road, maybe not right when I get out of college, but down the road, I would really enjoy coaching softball, and coaching hopefully either high school or possibly college girls. Specific entry-level position. I probably, after college, I'm going to pursue any entry-level position that's available, honestly, just because I don't exactly know what I want to do, so I may dip my feet in a few places and see what's there. And if at a candidate selection interview you're asked, what is the biggest challenge you have to overcome in your life so far? How might you respond? I would definitely say just, like, being away from home. I'm only 2 hours away, which I know a lot of other students at Bradley are a lot further away from home. But I'm just I'm a homebody, and I'm very family oriented. So being away from my family is hard, and not getting to be home for, you know, family dinners and big events like that, that you're used to, has been rough. But thankfully it's my senior year, so I only have one more year of getting through it. Well, half a year now, last semester, which is really exciting. But definitely just being away from home, being at school, being on your own. So yeah, I think that's all the questions. Let me know if you have any questions yourself, for me, and I'll be happy to answer them. Bye, guys.